So the Kansas lineup, Tyshawn Taylor back in the starting lineup, joined by Travis Relaford, Elijah Johnson, Thomas Robinson, and Jeff Withey for the 7-2, ranked number 11 in the country, Kansas Jayhawks, the Davidson Wildcats. From North Carolina, it's Kuhlman, Cochran, Droney, Cohen, and Damon Brooks, who is Davidson's leading scorer, although he fouled out of their last game at Charlotte. Bob McKellip now in his 23rd season as head coach at Davidson, one of the most respected head coaches. KU basketball first, Robinson right to the rim. Davidson's going to bring it back, and Sean, the Wildcats are not afraid to play in transition.
It's one of the things Bill Self pointed out to his team. He said, look, you might anticipate them coming in, trying to slow things down against us, but that's not what Davidson's doing this year. They're pushing the tempo, trying to create early offense.
Damon Brooks, Davidson's leading scorer, takes the first shot and misses, averaging 16 a game. So keep a very close eye on Tyshawn Taylor, number 10. You see just a slight sleeve, not even a brace on that right knee, 8 days after the meniscus tear. And as you mentioned, Sean, Bill Self saying, we're not even going to have a minute's cap on Tyshawn Taylor. He practiced fully yesterday, practiced part of the day on Saturday, and they feel like he is ready to go. And as long as the knee doesn't give him any problems, Tyshawn's not going to be limited.
Remember, he played 2 games with the meniscus injury. I was actually at the practice when he went down on the floor right before the Long Beach State game. He played through it on that night and then came back and had a career high in assists, 13, against the Buckeyes a week ago Saturday.
Damon Brooks gets the first bucket for Davidson. 6-3 record on the year for the Davidson Wildcats, who compete in the Southern Conference, the SoCo. Always play a very tough schedule. Those losses this year at Duke, home to Vanderbilt, who was a top 10 team at the time, and then at Charlotte. But it's been a 9-day break for exams for Davidson. So Russ not showing early as Davidson's out to a 4-0 start. Timeout, Bill Self.
Bill Self is irate with his team, and it's at both ends of the floor right now for the Jayhawks. They have come out flat.
There were some Kansas fans that were a little bit worried about this one tonight. Plus, you're, even though this is very much a Kansas environment, you're playing away from the field house.
Careless turnovers will have plagued the Jayhawks throughout the course of this season.
Travis Relaford takes a contested long two, and there's Damon Brooks for the rebound. Robinson tips it away on the post entry, intended for Cohen. So here's Tyshawn Taylor bringing Kansas back. Relaford on the wing finds Taylor for three.
Great job by Davidson shoring up their defensive glass, not allowing second chance opportunities for Kansas.
Kansas starts 0 for 4 from the floor. Tom Droney, the sophomore point guard from Pittsburgh, finds Brooks for three, and it's a 7-0 start for Davidson. Kansas doesn't have a point. Davidson has gone 3 for 4 from the floor to start.
And Damon Brooks, you mentioned it, he is the leading scorer, and when he's got to stay out of foul trouble. He has fouled out of 3 games this season. He avoids foul trouble. He averages close to 21 points per game with 3 or fewer fouls during the course of the game, and he's off to a very clean start so far.
Robinson gets around Brooks to get the first Kansas bucket. Cochran to a trailing Brooks, misses the three. Thomas Robinson clears. Davidson quickly back to stop the Kansas transition. Taylor picks up his dribble, and there's Robinson on to Relaford. Taylor to Robinson, drawing a foul on Jake Cohen. That two-man game between Taylor and Robinson.
Well, take a look right here. What you're going to see is you're going to see Brooks come off the screen, pop up onto the outside. He's going to have a wide-open shot. And again, one of the most dangerous guys is the guy setting the screen in your offensive end of the floor. A very unselfish move to try to open up your teammates, but maybe even more importantly, it opens yourself up as the defense has to react to those cutting off your screen.
What makes this Davidson offense and what they do in the half court so difficult?
Well, I think they've got great patience. They're a very smart team. They play with a high basketball IQ, and what that means is they don't make mistakes. They don't usually hurt themselves with foolish turnovers.
Sheehan shot missed, partially blocked, and now possession arrow will give it back to Davidson.
The other thing, too, about this Davidson team, this is one of the best teams that coach has had as far as taking you off the bounce. And so a little bit more aggressive of a team. So they can put pressure on you, which is a good thing when you're third in the nation in free throw percentage at 80% as a team on the season.
Bob McKillop says the main thing this team being a young team. No one left from that 2008 team that went to the regional final, the Stephen Curry team that played Kansas, nearly went to the Final Four. Bowman throws that one away. He's learning how to win. Learning how not just to compete in these games, but to win. Elijah Johnson misses the three. Coleman there for the board.
Johnson coming off his best game of the season from behind the arc. 5 of 7 from three against Ohio State. He's been very streaky this season.
Kansas just 1 for 7 shooting to begin this game. Elijah Johnson picks up the first personal foul. First team foul against Kansas.
And Elijah Johnson in the offseason worked so hard on developing a better consistency from the outside. You know, coming in at Midnight Madness when I was there talking with Coach Self, they really felt his offseason workout was going to carry over into this new role. And it's tough for people to remember. When you look at Johnson, Relaford, and Robinson, they were complementary parts for Kansas. Now they are asked to perform night in and night out, and they are the focal point of their opponents. It's a different, much different mindset for a player.
Thomas Robinson's minutes have doubled. Kansas off to a 1-for-7 shooting start. Davidson with an early edge.
To shoot the jump shot, but shoot it on a good solid ball reversal or when the defense is pinched in and you're kicking it out to somebody who's got their feet underneath them like a Connor Tehan.
Taylor on the wing. Kicks it out to Johnson for another jumper and another miss for Kansas. 1-for-8 start. Tehan with the offensive board. Tehan takes it himself in the corner. Make it 1-for-9, and there you go, Sean. That one interior, everything else perimeter jump shots.
Play for Thomas Robinson. See if you can get Damon Brooks into foul trouble. Get yourself to the free throw line.
Clinton Mann misses the dunk. Clint Mann for Davidson had a dunk to put him up 9-2 and missed. Now can Kansas take advantage? Taylor nearly turns it over. Elijah Johnson with another outside J that clangs. Robinson there for the offensive board and fouled on the floor.
Clint Mann at the opposite end of the floor. You see a nice job pump faking. Wesley gets up into the rim but doesn't go all the way through. Snaps its way back out. Great job by the officials in this contest. Clint Mann had an easy one.
And then Mann gets a foul on the other end. A homecoming game for both Clint Mann, for Davidson, and for Tyler Kalinowski from the Kansas City area. Clint Mann's from Overland Park. Tyler from Olathe, Kansas. And Bob McKillop, that's one of the reasons why he scheduled this game. They try to get players who come to Davidson from around the country, try to get a road game back at those home locations, if that makes any sense. A road game at a home location.
I'm following you.
Okay.
I've got you, but right now I'm watching this and I'm thinking to myself, here you are towing that line. You're Thomas Robinson. You've got off to a great start this season. And KU suffering to find points. I mean, Thomas Robinson has 3 and everybody else has failed to score yet and continue to jack up perimeter shots. I think be aggressive, continue to get a piece of the paint. KU cannot live behind the arc tonight against Davidson.
At the same time, Davidson, with Kansas shooting 1-for-10, still only up by 4. So the Wildcats, as of yet, unable to take advantage. Damon Brooks takes it straight to the hoop. He has 7 points. Bill Self takes his 2nd.
All right, maybe we should look to accomplish something else. Do something else in our half-court sets. Right now, Kansas has not made that adjustment.
Tyshawn Taylor still on the floor. He's yet to get a rest. Again, 8 days after surgery for a torn meniscus. Taylor has played the first 5.5 minutes for KU. Lots of whipping on the backside from Johnson.
Well, there's something different. That's just great half-court execution going towards the rim. A great call by Bill Self and the coaching staff coming out of that timeout.
Cochran off the shot fake. Taylor right there with him. On to Brooks, who turns it over.
A different level of intensity right now for Kansas, and coming right out of the break, what you're going to see is Withy on this side of the floor. Watch his movement after the ball's reversed. He's going to set the screen, and when he sets the screen, that's really just to free up space to go up over the top and finish at the rim. Nice job. Great execution by the Jayhawks.
Four turnovers for Davidson in the first 6 minutes. Davidson started this game 7-0 on 11th-ranked Kansas. First meeting since the 2008 Midwest Regional Final. Post-entry, there's Robinson again.
And what Thomas Robinson does an excellent job is keeping that ball high, not bringing it down low, not putting the ball down on the ground to allow a guard to get his hands in.
Brooks misses. Taylor running Kansas. Throws it away. Sending Kuhlman back in then Relaford with a foolish foul in the open floor. Tuesday night, Holiday Hoops doubleheader on the U. It's Bucknell against number one Syracuse, the 9 Eastern College of Charleston against fourth-ranked Louisville. Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers on ESPNU tomorrow night starting at 7 Eastern. Not only number one Syracuse, but definitive number one Syracuse in today's poll.
What a great week it's been on ESPNU. Syracuse, Louisville, North Carolina was just on before us. We've got the Jayhawks right now.
And with the power out in San Francisco, we welcome you to Monday Night Basketball from Kansas City. Cochran turns it over. Relaford brings it back.
Just a complete change, and I know you feel it in the building. The energy level much better for Kansas out of that last timeout. Bill Self not happy when Brooks went from the high post area, got an easy layup, and since that point in time, the Jayhawks have responded to what Coach Self was telling them on the sideline, and they're playing with a much better focus.
Since that second timeout by Bill Self, a 5-0 run for Kansas. 9-3 when he takes that second timeout. Mann picks up his second personal, so Mann's going to check out. Brooks back into the game, the sophomore from Charlotte. Davidson's leading scorer, and now Tom Droney back in to run the point.
Clint Mann, he's often in foul trouble. He has fouled out of 3 of their 9 games so far this season, and it's imperative to have size. They don't have a lot of size and depth on this Davidson roster. He has to avoid these type of situations where he's forced to go to the bench.
After trailing 7-0, Kansas has come back to tie at 9-9, 7 minutes in against Davidson. Kalinowski, the Kansas native who can shoot it, puts Davidson back up top.
I love the way he plays. I like his shot. It's always ready. It's always in the right pocket. And just talking to him before the game, he's excited that he's playing in front of his family and friends.
Tehan, offensive foul on Connor Tehan, number one.
Danny Manning gave him the scouting report today, and he said, if you drive middle, just be aware, Davidson is going to take charges. And Connor Tehan evidently wanted to test that theory, and he found out that they are indeed going to sit there and be willing to sacrifice their body. Davidson very good at the defensive end, rotating over in help side position.
5-out offense for the Wildcats. Brooks trying to cut to the rim. Kuhlman behind the screen finds Droney. Cohen from 18. Good rebound there from Justin Wesley. Nadir Tharp, the freshman backup point guard, turns it over, going a little too quick on the baseline. However, Kansas is going to keep it. That was off a Davidson player.
And Nadir Tharp is a talented freshman for Kansas, but has really kind of pretzeled himself mentally in the early stages of this season, trying to do too much.
And then Connor Tehan commits a foul. Second personal, that's a turnover. And Tehan, Wesley, and Tharp right back to the bench prior to the under 12 official timeout. Fourth turnover by the Jayhawks. Davidson led this game 7-0. Kansas back to tie it at 9. And Kalinowski from Olathe, Kansas, turns it over on this trip down. Six turnovers for Davidson in the first 8 minutes. Robinson draws the double. Robinson fights through the double. Sloppy pass. Davidson brings it back with a three-point lead. Kuhlman finds a trailing Cohen. Back-to-back threes by Davidson. And if the Wildcats can get the three-point shot going, very dangerous team tonight and throughout the year.
Well, Cohen in particular, you know, not often you see a man 6'10" on the outside shooting three. Kind of reminds me of St. Louis's Rob Lowe, who likes to shoot the transition three-point look.
Davidson running with a six-point lead, turning it over. Taylor brings it back. Three on two for Kansas. Taylor right to the rim. Offensive foul. And what was the point from Danny Manning, who had the scouting report in this game? They will take the charge. Up next. Number one seeds, Kansas over Memphis in that terrific overtime final in San Antonio to give Bill Self his first national title. Davidson turns and leads to a Johnson dunk off the dish from Taylor.
Davidson is shooting 55% from the floor, but they continue to turn it over. Eight turnovers in the early stages of this game.
Cohen misses the three. Robinson yanks it. Three rebounds for Thomas Robinson to go along with his 5 points.
Playing a team like Kansas, you have to value the basketball.
Relliford hands it off the pick and roll. Davidson led this game 7-0. Kansas came back to tie at 9-9. And now it's the Jayhawks fighting back from a deficit against the Davidson Wildcats. Droney on the wing finds a slipping Damon Brooks, and Davidson's leading scorer, Damon Brooks, has 9 of the 17.
Thomas Robinson just lost his man. Momentary lapse out on the floor, and Brooks made him pay.
Robinson on the offensive end, high off the glass. Robinson has 7. Kalinowski turns the corner. Kick back to Cohen. Cans another three.
Just a beautiful job, and Davidson does this so often, where they dribble in to get a piece of the paint off that top curl, and they have someone filling from behind.
Cohen has a pair of threes. It's been the three-point shot that has taken Davidson now to a five-point lead.
Watch the way Thomas Robinson, his vision is over in this direction. He has no idea of where his man is. He cuts right in front of his face. He reacts way too late. Easy finish for Brooks at the rim.
Other end of the floor, Cohen commits his second foul, so he's going to have to sit. Damon Brooks gets a rest for Wildcats as well. So with Brooks and Cohen on the bench, can Davidson hang on to this five-point lead as the Jayhawks start to heat up from the floor? A lot better looks from Kansas, including that one in the corner. Doesn't go down for Johnson. Cochran finds Kalinowski in the corner. What a touch.
Kalinowski is going to be the next star of Davidson. Just a freshman, and already you've seen it here. 2 three-pointers in the early stages for this very talented and composed player.
You know, Bill Self made the comment. Robinson misses, and then Young loses it out of bounds. Bill Self made the comment, Davidson is going to be a good shooting team at some point. They're 80% from the free throw line, third in the nation. Tells you that this is a group that has good form, good touch. Haven't shot it well yet. And just hoping that it wasn't tonight that Davidson starts burying the three.
They are off to a great start from the outside. Kalinowski, though, if you watch the way he gets his feet set, that one not a very good look, but he does get his feet set underneath him almost every time.
Been easy with three defenders on him. Misses badly. Davidson gets it right back. Kuhlman. There's Kalinowski for the offensive board. Kalinowski on the floor. Jump ball, possession to Kansas, but the Kansas native, Tyler Kalinowski, gets the board and gets on the floor. Jump ball, alternate possession, Kansas.
Good hustle by Davidson, tracking down. Rebounds Kalinowski going for it. His teammates try to do the smart play and try to call the timeout, but it was too late. Jump ball already called by the officiating crew.
Bob McKillop said of Kalinowski, he has presence and poise rare from a freshman. Kalinowski chases this one down in the corner. Davidson running with an 8-point lead on Kansas. Cherepovich walks. Turnover number 9.
Easy to see him drag that foot just a little bit. The Kansas Jayhawks trying to get going, but it's been Davidson.
Kalinowski, who is shooting just 21% from 3-point. He's a better shooter than that. So at some point, they were going to wake up out of their slump. Averaging Davidson right around 7 made threes a game coming into tonight. Already 5 made threes for the Wildcats. None for Kansas.
Kansas' success has been when they've attacked the paint.
Taylor attacks the paint and draws a foul.
10 of the 15 points for Kansas coming inside the paint right now. As you mentioned, 0 for 6 from behind the arc. And when you attack the paint, you put pressure on the defense. The ability to draw fouls, get yourself to the free throw line, get players on the bench.
Carter Blackburn with Sean Farnham from the Sprint Center in downtown Kansas City. Frank Benizi draws a foul there for Davidson. Davidson led this game 7-0. Kansas came back to tie at 9-9. And now Davidson building its largest lead at 8 points on 11th-ranked Kansas. Sellout crowd here, as you might imagine in Kansas City. I would say 99.9% of them are pulling for the Jayhawks. But Davidson has done a good job of quieting the Kansas crowd. Mike Stewart saw that one go off of a Jayhawk, so it's Davidson basketball. Only 2 losses as part of that all-time record in Kansas City. Only 2 losses here in this building. Syracuse in overtime and UMass. 13-2 Kansas in this building.
Davidson giving a run here in the first half.
John, I'm sure you know this, you're a Kansas basketball expert, but Kansas' first game in 1899 was here in Kansas City. Chris Cherepovich drains the 3 to give Davidson an 11-point first-half lead against 11th-ranked Kansas.
They didn't have the 3-point line back there, but it's certainly paying off huge for Davidson in this one.
Thomas Robinson forced out, has to find Relaford, and then a foul by Cochran. That's his second. So fouls 2 now on Cochran, 2 on Cohen, 2 on Mann, and Kansas has reached the bonus.
And you can always see at the bottom portion of your screen where it says bonus in the box to let you know at home when they've reached that point. If there's a plus sign next to it, it means it's the double bonus. 2 free throw attempts.
So 7 team fouls against Davidson, meaning 1-1 here for Relaford. Missing the front end.
That kind of half for Kansas at the offensive end. You have got to be able to finish out a possession playing against Davidson.
Cherepovich misses the 3. Robinson boards. Kansas brings it back, trailing by 11. Taylor right to the rim. Contact, no whistle. And then Young loses it out of bounds. Another empty possession for Kansas.
And Tyshawn Taylor, you love his hustle. You love his toughness. You mentioned numerous times already, just 8 days after his surgery on that meniscus. But that time, too much over-dribble penetration will create those wild kind of shots.
Tom Droney on the dribble. This is DeMond Brooks, Davidson's leading scorer, guarded by Thomas Robinson, drawing him out. Pullman on the wing, shot clock to 10. Shot clock to 7. Relaford gets a steal. Relaford leading the break. Finds a trailing Taylor, who finds a trailing Johnson.
And that's the first 3-pointer made by the Jayhawks, and it's a big one. It gets these crowd back on their feet, but it all started because of their effort at the defensive end of the floor.
Droney finds Brooks behind the screen. Relliford runs it down. Could have been a walk. Stead into Robinson. Through the double and one. Back come the Jayhawks.
Well, you see, Thomas Robinson has been so physical underneath, and when you allow him to post up in the paint before the catch, it doesn't matter whether you bring the double team. He's going to be able to go right through it. And then you see just over dribble penetration by Kuhlman, and that allows for the run out and a good decision by Tyshawn Taylor to not take that shot from behind the arc, and sets up his teammate Elijah Johnson.
10 points now for Thomas Robinson. So 10 of Kansas 21 and 4 rebounds for Robinson. Trying to lead a Kansas comeback. Davidson led by as many as 11. Kalinowski off the bounce. Finds Droney. Long rebound comes back to Davidson.
Great tip by Kalinowski.
Brooks fouled. Couldn't get it to go.
See, those are the little things that you won't necessarily see in the box score and understand the importance. But Kalinowski getting that tip out, securing another opportunity to try to attack, and drawing a foul on Thomas Robinson because of Kalinowski's hustle.
First free throws of the night for Davidson. The team shooting 80%, third in the nation in team free throw shooting. Of course, Brooks misses the first.
Yeah, Brooks 84% from the line. You mentioned this already, but he fouled out after just 17 minutes of play against Charlotte. It was the second time that he's fouled out this season. Trying to work his way back into a rhythm.
Jay Cohen fouled out of that game as well. That's been a big problem for Davidson. Fouling and fouling out. Cohen and Brooks fouled out of that loss at Charlotte. 7 foul outs already as a team for Davidson. 7 foul outs in 10 games. Robinson gets the front end of the 1-1.
And how efficient has Thomas Robinson been the last couple of games? 17 of 23 from the field, Carter. Almost 74% shooting the last couple of games as he has really started to elevate his play. Only player in the Big 12 to average a double-double on the season, and he's not barely averaging one. He is doing it with authority.
47 points the last 2 games for Thomas Robinson. 26 against Long Beach State, 21 in the win over second-ranked Ohio State, minus Jared Sullinger. Robinson yanks that rebound, leading Kansas on the break. Jayhawks trail by 4. Trail by as many as 11 here in the first half against Davidson. Elijah Johnson on the wing out to Kevin Young. Johnson with a hand in his face buries the triple. Just the second made 3 for Kansas, and it's a 1-point game from 11 down. Kansas pulls within 1 of Davidson.
11-0, an easy victory tonight. And Indiana back in the top 25. And what a great scene that was for college basketball. To see Assembly Hall that excited once again about college basketball.
10-0 run by Kansas to turn an 11-point deficit into a 1-point game against Davidson. Brooks on the wing against Robinson. Travels. Kansas basketball with a chance to take the lead against Davidson after trailing by 11. Davidson Wildcats led by as many as 11. A 10-0 Kansas run has cut it to 1. And off the 12th Davidson turnover of the first half, Kansas has a chance to take its first lead here in Kansas City. Elijah Johnson on the wing down the baseline. Into the corner, T-hand triple. And Kansas leads for the first time tonight against Davidson.
Great execution coming out once again out of timeouts, knowing exactly how to find your teammate, And Connor Tehan is a guy that Bill Self told me 2 weeks ago, we've got to do a better job of understanding how to set the table for Connor Tehan because he can stretch you out on the perimeter.
After an 0-for-6 start from behind the arc, Kansas has made its last three threes and leads for the first time tonight. Kuhlman cutting to the basket off the feed from Kalinowski. Breakdown in Kansas defense, and Tyshawn Taylor is going to check back in at the next whistle. Robinson wants it on the post. Matched up against a 6'5 Regal, but a Kansas turnover gives Brooks a missed layup. And now after that sloppy exchange between the two, Davidson ball. How did that one go in, Sean?
Off balance, one leg, throw it up towards the rim, and draws nothing but the net.
That is an H if you're playing horse with J.P. Kuhlman, guaranteed.
Now Kuhlman at the opposite end of the floor, we've seen him try to do a little bit too much this time. Really off balance, didn't get good elevation on it, but nice soft touch.
Yeah, nice soft running one-hander over the All-America caliber Thomas Robinson, listed 6'10". Hey,
you know, Davidson has done so many things right here in the first half. The biggest mistake, and I will continue to harp on it, though, is the turnovers. They have got to settle themselves down and play with a little bit better composure. They were lucky they didn't turn that ball over in that last possession at least three times. They could have easily turned the ball over.
Robinson goes 0-for-2 from the foul line. A chance to even it once again for Kansas. Kick ball. Sean, those turnovers from Davidson, how much of that is Kansas defense and how much of it is just sloppy offense from the Wildcats?
I think it's more so on the Wildcats. They're just trying to overcommit, trying to make the sensational play. Just make the simple one like that.
Kuhlman, kick out. Three won't go for Cherepovich. Kansas on the run down by two.
But that was a better possession. You know, you could have forced up a layup. Instead, you found a wide open shooter in the corner. Go ahead and hit him.
Taylor refuses the screen and throws it away. Another turnover for Tyshawn Taylor. Kuhlman right to the rim. Davidson back up by four.
Poor defensive transition. Wide open, middle of the paint. Nobody pinching in from the outside. Communicating on the back line for the Jayhawks. That's 2 points for Davidson.
J.P. Kuhlman has six for Davidson. Taylor kicks to the corner. Tehan misses the three. Long rebound to Davidson.
Tehan got off to such a great start against the 49ers of Long Beach State. 4-for-4.
That one will not go in the game of horse for J.P. Kuhlman. Taylor takes it right at the rim and draws the foul this time on Cherepovich. So block on Cherepovich earlier, a charge.
Well, see, a couple possessions ago, he didn't go for the shot. He turns it over, goes in the opposite direction. Nobody stepping over defensively to stop the ball. And Kuhlman able to finish. And I think the one thing that Davidson's done a nice job of here in the first half is when the Jayhawks regain the lead, Davidson quickly gathered themselves back and got the lead right back. And I think when you're playing a team like Kansas, you don't want to allow them to build momentum, go on a run, excite this crowd. And as you've mentioned time and time again, the Wildcats have kept this crowd, this sold-out crowd here at the Sprint Center, at a pretty minimum level.
Tyshawn Taylor hasn't scored tonight, including missing that first free throw. Averages 16 a game. Kansas finally gets a free throw. They missed their last four. Do you notice any difference with Tyshawn Taylor getting up and down the floor 8 days after the knee surgery?
He's definitely taking a little bit of a step back in the speed of the department as far as that first step, getting down low, accelerating by his defensive man.
Kuhlman, 18-footer is short. Long rebound, Robinson yanks it. Thomas Robinson leads the break and then makes a great decision to pull it back out. Thomas Robinson was joking around playing point guard earlier today at shoot-around. That looked like a pretty heady move for a point forward, point center.
That was a good move, as you mentioned, to pull it back out, reestablish the offense. And Thomas Robinson making those type of smart plays.
Kansas only 50% from the line, less than that now. Jordan Juniman on the floor for Kansas right now, maybe not for long. He had played all of 9 minutes this year. So what does it tell you that Jordan Juniman is at least on the floor in this first half against Davidson?
Bill Self is looking for guys who want to commit themselves to the defensive end of the floor and maybe not rush things so much on the offensive end, play a more cohesive offensive approach.
Had a good conversation with Coach Self earlier today about depth and what depth and this year lack of depth does for a team. Less ability to use that bench as a motivator.
It's so key you remember this great roster. I mean, Thomas Robinson was coming off the bench a year ago.
Cheropovich fouled on the way to the lane.
And some rare free throws here in the first half for Davidson.
Davidson hasn't scored from the free throw line, a team who shoots 80% from the line. And usually pretty good at getting to the line. Cheropovich, a native of Sweden, makes it 0 for 3 in this first half for Davidson. So not exactly the recipe that you would say for a halftime lead against Kansas.
And unbelievable that they have yet to put one in, as you mentioned, as we both mentioned. Third in the NCAA from the free throw line. That's the first one to go down. But Cheropovich, a great job this summer playing with the U-20 team nationally for Sweden. Great experience to go against international competition. Feels like you've come back with a little bit more confidence. He shot the ball extremely well from behind the arc the last three games, better than 52%.
So 12 turnovers, 1-for-4 shooting from Davidson from the free throw line in the first half, and yet a three-point edge. Kansas has a chance to just about milk it to the half. Tyshawn Taylor takes it himself, pulling Kansas within one. Davidson unable to get the shot off before the half. So the Wildcats lead by one.
They feel if they eliminate the turnovers, they put themselves up in a much better position to win this game as they've been shooting the higher percentage throughout the entire first half. The other thing they want to do, spread the floor a lot more than they did in the first half. Force Thomas Robinson to come out and guard.
How surprising is it when you look at those numbers? Second chance points. Correction. Second chance points for Kansas. Only 1 point off a second chance for the Jayhawks.
And that number has to be up around 20, really, for Kansas to be successful. They are a team that does a very good job working the offensive glass. Withy is one of those guys that has to get on the board. One rebound in the first half for him, and he doesn't start the second half as Connor Tehan's out there.
Tyshawn Taylor starts the second half. He started the first just 8 days after knee surgery for a torn meniscus. Tehan misses the three to get it started for Kansas. Davidson in transition. Wildcats have numbers. Cochran to a trailing Cohen, who's out there with two personal fouls. Mann has two personals as well. He does not start the second half for Davidson. Triple goes for Cochran, the seventh made three of the game for Davidson.
Good ball movement, good patience, find yourself a wide open look. Five different Wildcats now have hit a three-pointer in this game.
Thomas Robinson draws the double for Kansas. Johnson, dribble drive, floater goes.
An awareness that they're there to take the charge. He did an excellent job jump stopping and elevating with a floater from about 5 feet away.
10 points for Elijah Johnson now. Both these teams coming off the breaks for finals, 9 days in between games for Davidson and Kansas. Last time the Jayhawks were on the floor, it was at Allen Fieldhouse defeating second-ranked Ohio State without Jared Sullinger. Travis Relliford bumped on the way to the hoop by Damon Brooks. While we have just a second, I want to wish Kansas football coach Charlie Weiss, new Kansas football coach Charlie Weiss, best, recovering from hip surgery, successful hip surgery this morning. So best to Charlie Weiss in his recovery from that hip surgery, and that is not only from us, but from everybody at Kansas Athletics here. sure he will be back on the recruiting trail quickly.
And Jeff Withey starting the second half on the bench, just one for one from the field, one rebound in 9 minutes played. And this is a difficult matchup for him because of how Davidson will spread the floor and try to take you away from the rim.
Second chance here for the Jayhawks.
Grimace on Taylor's face as he went into his move.
Tyshawn Taylor has made only one shot tonight. He's one for five now from the floor. Slow getting up on Taylor. That's the third foul on Jake Cohen, who fouled out of the last game at Charlotte. Just 21 minutes, and now he picks up the third personal here. On the floor, at least thus far.
It's not been an easy night for Tyshawn Taylor, and that knee seemingly bothering him on that possession in particular. On the catch, he had this look on his face as if it didn't feel just right. You know, you love the heart, you love the passion, you love the desire to be out on the floor, but I think that's something that this coaching staff for Kansas will keep a close eye on in the second half if he's not moving right or feeling right.
And to reiterate what Bill Self told us earlier today about Tyshawn Taylor, he was back on the floor on Friday, practice Saturday, full go practice on Sunday, saw no ill effects, said he had no pain. So Tyshawn came to Coach Self and said, hey, I'm healthy. If I can play, I'm going to go. So don't worry about limiting my minutes. He played 16 minutes in the first half, and Tyshawn Taylor has played the first two-plus of this second half. So there's not a specific limit on it. How about that look? Robinson to Johnson. That's the KU rocking the rim Jayhawk fans are used to. Third time we've been tied tonight. Fouled on the way to the hoop.
And Clint Mann goes down hard. And he is grabbing that right shoulder.
Get any update on Clint Mann, but we'll pass it along to you. Chris Cheropovich to the free throw line.
And not a bad substitution.
No.
Mann shoots 47% from the free throw line. Cheropovich 72%.
So again, Mann was the player fouled. Cheropovich is his substitution with Mann on the bench because of the injury. He gets them both. Six for Cheropovich. Davidson back on top. Wildcats led by as many as 11 in the first half. Tyshawn Taylor down the baseline. He's now one for six shooting in the game. Droney slips the screen. Gets it back in the corner. Droney, the sophomore from Pittsburgh. Brooks right around Tyshawn Taylor. Got the mismatch, and Damon Brooks, Davidson's leading scorer on the year, has 13 tonight.
6 of 11 from the field. Very efficient. Two baskets now in the early stages where he's posted up deep and been able to finish.
Thomas Robinson has a face-up answer. 13 points, 10 rebounds for Thomas Robinson. Double-double for the player who's averaging a double-double this year.
Set a school record with 6 double-doubles to start off the season.
Cheropovich draws the D. Droney misses the three. Tehan saves it. Elijah Johnson runs Kansas. Robinson off the shot fake. Draws a foul on Brooks. That's number 3 on Damon Brooks. When Brooks stays on the floor, dangerous weapon for Davidson.
He averages 20 points plus strength down low.
Good news in his homecoming game again. He's from Overland Park, Kansas, nearby. One of the reasons Davidson scheduled this game. He and Kolonoski, both Kansas natives. Sean, if I were to tell you at the Haven, guess who's coming back in? Here is Clint Mann. Glenn Mann back on the block for Davidson. Robinson gets the second free throw.
Back to a one-point game. And Davidson's got to work in this possession. Don't settle for an early shot. Make Kansas guard you.
Instead, a three from the perimeter. Relaford runs down the rebound and then draws a foul on Cochran. That'll be number three on him. So Cochran and Brooks both have three. And Cohen. All three of them have three fouls.
You got to be careful with these early long shots leading to long rebounds, opportunities for runouts for the Jayhawks.
Tehan behind the double screen.
Great communication defensively by Davidson to get out there and cover that.
Robinson wants it on the post. Elijah Johnson instead dribbling on the wing. 8 seconds to shoot. Robinson has to come out to get it against Clint Mann. Robinson hoists it with four. Good rebound from Chirapovich for Davidson. Underneath Mann, fouled hard. He hits the deck again, but Mann earns a trip to the free throw line.
And the thing that impressed me most about that possession by Clint Mann was that he worked early. And when I say he worked early, that means in transition. Watch the way he fights here with Thomas Robinson. He runs right into him. Look how deep he is, gaining that post position down low. That's great toughness.
Talk about getting position down low, and you usually think of that in like a half-court offense sense. Man there, that's in the open court where he's gaining position on Robinson.
And that's doing your work early. There's very few players in college basketball do their work early on a consistent basis. You know, Robert Sacre is a guy that comes to mind for Gonzaga. I was talking with Brad Stevens tonight about their game tomorrow night, as I'll be up in Spokane for that. And it's very rare to have a player that can put pressure on you by posting up in transition.
With the magic of television, you will be in Spokane, Washington tomorrow night, Sean Farnham. Elijah Johnson misses the three. Long rebound for Tehan. Kansas has more offensive rebounds in the second half already than they had in the first. Johnson, another triple try. Davidson brings it back with a two-point lead. Cochran finds a trailing man who puts it on the deck. And now Mann spinning around with you. Clint Mann has his first field goal. Davidson by four.
Good footwork by Mann to stay on balance. And Jayhawks getting second chance opportunities, just not converting them.
And one. Count the bucket for Whitney. And a foul on Mann. Good repost there by Jeff Whitney to get the ball.
Jeff Whitney down low on the block. We mentioned limit in the first half. And so many times at practice, and three out of the last four games for Kansas, I've had the opportunity to cover this team. So I've been to a lot of their practices. And Danny Manning does such a great job with their interior presence. And one of the things he is consistently on Jeff Whitney about is keeping the ball high on the catch. Just go to the jump hook. Nobody's going to block it. You can find yourself some easy points. And that was a clear example of what Danny Manning has been preaching to Jeff Whitney so far this season.
Whitney finishes off the three-point play. One-point game again. Four Davidson Wildcats have three or more fouls with nearly 14 minutes to go in regulation. Well, Kansas and Davidson went down to the wire the last time they got together in 2008. Here in Kansas City, the Final Four may not be on the line, but it's
the foul trouble. Because coming down the stretch of this game, you're going to get in tight physical possessions. Guys start fouling out. Then you start looking for others that may not be accustomed to having to step up in their role and knock down shots.
Cochran behind a screen from Ben Easy. Misses the three. Droney there for the board and the stick back. Davidson back up by three. Scoring out of the timeout. Relaford gives it up to Taylor. slipping the screen from Young. Tyshawn Taylor has just his second made bucket of the game.
Starting to move with a little bit better fluidity on that drive.
Cochran hands this three. Missed it badly the last time. Eighth made three of the game for Davidson.
But every time Kansas starts to get back in this game and starts to get to the point where they can gain the lead, Davidson always answers.
Tehan can't answer for the Jayhawks. Peroni running Davidson into the front court. Another good screen from Ben Easy. On to Damon Brooks, Davidson's leading scorer. Brooks draws a foul on Kevin Young.
Anytime you see that matchup, I attack Kevin Young. They're just must last possession. Nice screen. You go underneath the screen against Davidson, and they're going to make you pay. Communication has to be there, even in transition, to fight over the top of that screen.
Johnson right there with Cochran on the catch this time. Cochran around the screen from Ben Easy. Long two. Correction, it's Kalinowski who takes that long two. And then a foul against Ben Easy after the rebound, drawing the ire of Bob McKillop. Correction, that foul is on Brooks, and that is four on Damon Brooks. So with Davidson up by four, 12-11 to go, Damon Brooks has to sit with four personal fouls. Sean, you said before this game started, one of the big keys for Davidson was keeping Damon Brooks out of foul trouble.
Well, he's in there now, and somebody else has to elevate their play. That's a great call. Jeff Withey with the moving pick on the outside. You got to set your feet underneath you. It counts as a turnover. Resulted in 3 points for Kansas. So when you do have opportunities to get those second chance looks, you've got to finish them.
Davidson's leading scorer, Damon Brooks, is on the bench with four personal fouls. He has 13 points tonight. So can Davidson get offense without Damon Brooks on the floor? Thomas Robinson has 12 rebounds, already a double-double tonight. With these scores, Kansas back within two.
Love the way Jeff Whitney's responded after not starting the second half.
Cohen takes it right at Robinson and Whitney. Davidson gets it back. Cochran nails the three. Bob McKillop jumping up and down in front of the Davidson bench.
That's twice in this half already. The lead has been shrunk to two, and Cochran has stepped up and hit a big three.
Nine made threes in the game for Davidson. Robinson has it poked away by Cohen. Big no call there. That would have been the fourth foul on Cohen. There is Jake Cohen guarded by Robinson. Droney behind his screen, poked away by Johnson. Davidson ball, 14 on the shot clock.
Coach McKillop working hard on the sideline. His team working hard on the court. Second chance opportunities for Davidson pays off with the long three-pointer.
So Davidson has more second chance scoring in this game than Kansas. Missed three from Kalinowski leads to a run out and then a foul. That's Cochran who fouls, and that's the fourth on Cochran. So two Davidson starters have four personal fouls. Cochran's going to come out. Terapovich and Kuhlman back in for Davidson.
Well, and that's the kind of foul you have to have an awareness. I have three personal fouls. It's open floor situation. You get yourself out of position, and you pick up your fourth foul, and you hurt your team by going to the bench. And Cochran's got to be smarter than that.
Cochran and Brooks both have four. Cohen and Mann each have three. So that's four of the top six in the rotation for Davidson, all dealing with foul trouble and a long way to go. Taylor misses the front end. Withey's there for the board. Now can Kansas score? Sean, as you said, opportunities off the offensive rebounds for Kansas that they are not converting.
Well, and how quiet has Thomas Robinson been in the second half? and getting Thomas Robinson looks here in the second half. He has one made field goal and only 3 points.
Kalinowski, the Kansas native, off the screen. Kalinowski, kick out to Kuhlman. Cohen off the shot big. Robinson doesn't bite. Ten to shoot. Man. Handing off to Kuhlman. Kalinowski gives it up to Man. Two to shoot. Relaford yanks the rebound. Kansas gets the defensive stop. Tyshawn Taylor slow getting back on offense. Elijah Johnson off the curl screen. Finds Thomas Robinson. Wyatt no more. Timeout, Davidson. Robinson rocks it to bring Kansas back all the way down to two, forced a bad shot and scored off of it, but it began with the defense in that last 10 seconds by Kansas.
Great point, Carter.
Thank you. I've been learning from you, Sean. Watching all of your many Kansas basketball games this year. Whitney recovers the block, man.
Just completely lost, though, defensively in the dump down, but Withy able to utilize his length and his hustle to get back and make a play.
15 to shoot for Davidson. Into Kuhlman. Quick jumper, no. Battle for the rebound, won by Davidson, and a foul underneath. Cohen got bumped.
And Coach McKillop working so hard on the sideline right now as his guys continue to scrap. That's the one thing. I think this Davidson team, they are scrappy on the offensive end. Finding second chance opportunities, getting their hands on balls, tipping them out.
Bob McKillop, the Queens, New York native, now in his 23rd season coaching Davidson. I think a lot of people around basketball enjoyed that 2008 run to the Elite Eight. Davidson took Kansas to the wire because there's so much respect in the coaching ranks for Bob McKillop. I think not only he enjoyed that, Davidson fans, a lot of folks around basketball enjoyed it.
Well, and he said, you know, we asked him, what do you remember about that 08 run? He goes, we pinched ourselves and we savored it. We enjoyed it all the way through.
So it's kind of like your wedding day. It goes by so fast, but you have to take time to savor it.
Good job rotating defensively by Davidson, fighting through the screens.
Hard hedge on the screen, leaves Withy wide open underneath.
What a pass by Elijah Johnson. That is not an easy pass in the double team near the half court line to find your big.
Kuhlman around the screen. Robinson yanks it. 14 rebounds now for Thomas Robinson. Kansas takes a timeout, trailing by three. First game, one of those guys who's had to play a much bigger role with all of the defections, including Josh Shelby to the NBA. Johnson setting up the Kansas half-court offense against the Davidson zone.
Yeah, Davidson switches up out of the break, goes to the zone.
11 to shoot. Johnson takes the three. Robinson loses the offensive board. Cohen yanks it away. Davidson led by as many as 11 in the first half. It's way off.
That's an ill-advised shot. I know they want to push the ball up, create tempo and opportunities, but you can get that opportunity on any possession. A contested three-point shot with no rebounders underneath.
Robinson fouled underneath. Even with Davidson's leading scorer, Damon Brooks on the bench with four personal fouls, the Wildcats.
What they're doing, though, is they're getting second chance opportunities, Carter, and they're settling for perimeter shots, contested looks. Thomas Robinson is the best player in the building. Get him the ball. Find a way to post Thomas Robinson up. You've got a bunch of guys in foul trouble for Davidson. There is no reason you can't continue to attack underneath.
Glenn Mancheck's back into the game for Davidson with three personal fouls. Brooks and Cochran are both on the Davidson bench with four personal fouls. So 7:37 to go. We'll see how long Bob McKillop leaves DeMond Brooks on the bench. Davidson's leading scorer, Brooks, has 13 in this game. Cochran on the bench has 11. So Davidson's two leading scorers in this game are on the bench right now in foul trouble. Three-point shot from Cheropovich won't go. Robinson yanks rebound number 15. That's two away from his career high. Robinson turns it over. Droney brings it back. Robinson recovers to swat it away.
You make up for a mistake with hustle getting back on defense, and Thomas Robinson knows he made a mistake at the offensive end of the floor. But great hustle getting back. He loses the handle, and watch the hustle by Thomas Robinson. The timing perfect as he cleans it up.
Robinson give it and take it.
And you mentioned Robinson now 16 rebounds, just one away from his career high.
Off the inbound, Kuhlman had a look at a three, passed on it. Kalinowski, the Kansas native, finds Cohen back on the floor with three personal fouls. Cohen takes the three. Kansas with an opportunity to regain the lead. Davidson led by as many as 11 in this game. Taylor's tripped, earning a trip to the free throw line.
This may not be Allen Fieldhouse, but it certainly has erupted with the fanfare. And you see Taylor go down, and anytime he hits the floor right now, I think there's got to be reasons to take a second look and make sure he gets back up off the floor. Having that meniscus surgery a week ago Sunday.
A senior from Hoboken, New Jersey, legendary St. Anthony's. Gets a second free throw. Fourth time we've been tied tonight. Even at 55, Davidson has threatened 11th-ranked Kansas here in Kansas City, leading by 11 at the half, maintaining a one-point lead at the break. Even now with 6.5 to go.
You'd like to keep Brooks on the bench for Davidson until that four-minute timeout, and then you just got to let him kind of play through. And if he fouls out, he fouls out. But he has been offense, and they're missing that offense right now, settling for a lot of perimeter shots for Davidson.
Taylor leaves it short, still tied at 55. To shoot. Kuhlman on the catch. Robinson pulls down the rebound.
Ties his career high with 17. I want to see Thomas Robinson get on the block.
Withy kicks it around to Relliford. Withy gets it back at the high post. Two opportunities for Kansas to take their first lead of the second half. Now can Davidson regain the lead? Kuhlman push shot, makes it Davidson by two again.
Kuhlman looks so awkward going to the rim every time on the release, but it's effective.
Vinny Del Negro-esque. I'll take credit for that one, Sean. I don't want anybody thinking you called him out for that one. Relliford into the lane. Let's see who this foul is on. Blocking foul against Droney. That's his first. 10 team fouls, so Kansas double bonus, at least two free throw shots the rest of the way for the Jayhawks.
Davidson, you got to give him credit. Every single time the Jayhawks have got this crowd in the game, had an opportunity to take the lead, they have fought their way back.
And with 5:19 to go, DeMond Brooks is going to check back into the game for Davidson. Credit the Wildcats for doing a terrific job holding on to the lead. He picked up his fourth personal foul at 12-11. So sitting for nearly 7 minutes, and Davidson did not surrender the lead. Kansas was able to tie it, but not take the lead. Brooks back out on the floor with four personal fouls. Coleman triple. Davidson will not go away. Timeout Kansas. Davidson has a 4-point lead. They've knocked down 10 of them. Better from three than two.
4-point lead once again for Davidson. I still want to see Thomas Robinson catch the ball on the block. And I have yet to see him post up extremely hard here in the last couple of possessions.
Taylor tries to get it to him. Cohen takes it away. Right into two Davidson defenders. Wildcats push it up by four. Cohen right around the defender Johnson.
And those are the type of turnovers that'll drive you nuts with Tajon Taylor.
Largest lead of the second half for Davidson at 6 points.
It's basically an outlet pass for the Wildcats to go on down to the other end.
Thomas Robinson down the baseline. Draws a blocking foul. Count the bucket. And that foul is on DeMond Brooks. It will be his fifth.
And Coach McKillop is beside himself. But I love the fact that Robinson called for the ball. We could hear him as we're sitting here at half court saying, ball, ball, give me the ball. And his teammates found him. And Brooks tried to slide over to take the charge. And you see it clear as day. Watch. Look at him calling for the ball. And your go-to player needs to make plays. And Brooks' feet still sliding sideways. Never really set. And a great job and a strong finish for Robinson.
Davidson maintained the lead when Brooks had to go to the bench with four personal fouls. He sat for nearly 5 minutes. Davidson didn't surrender the lead. Now Davidson up by four. Brooks fouls out. So the leading scorer for Davidson is fouled out. This is the third time that Brooks has fouled out this season, including the last two games. Fouled out in the loss to Charlotte. Fouls out here in Kansas City. Robinson spins in to finish the three-point play. 21 points, 17 rebounds for Thomas Robinson.
They've needed every single one of them so far, and they're going to need a lot more in these final 4 minutes from Thomas Robinson.
Kalinowski triple. Rebound from Mann. Second chance for Kalinowski. Taylor pushes the Jayhawks. Coleman off the Robinson miss. Coleman finds Cohen. Davidson scoring in transition to go up five.
If you would have told Coach McKillop late in the game, Cohen would post up deep in the paint and be able to score on Thomas Robinson, he'd probably snicker.
Robinson contested two. Relaford there to help him out.
And Coach McKillop wants his guys to establish their offense and work the shot clock. He goes ahead and calls a timeout.
McKillop takes a 30-second timeout. For the first time since the 2008 regional final went down to the wire. Davidson led by as many as 11 in the first half. Clint Mann finds a back-cutting Cochran, who is fouled by Connor Tehan. 3-point game, 3:04 to go. Enjoy those big games, enjoy those big moments. And they would love to enjoy another one tonight. I mean, this, Sean, how big would this win be for a Davidson team who is 6-3, who Bob McKillop says, we are learning again to compete, to win in big games. That ability that a team from OA had.
Well, you go back to that Steph Curry team. They played in a lot of big games, but they knew how to win a lot of big games. And for this team, a lot of young faces, new roles, being asked to do different things. These guys aren't accustomed to being in this situation with the lead. You know, they play one of the more difficult non-conference schedules in the country. So they've been tested already. They're not going to be scared about the environment, but they've got to learn how to finish games off, and we'll see if they can do it tonight.
Tyshawn Taylor gets a tough runner to pull Kansas within three. A Davidson team who lost 9 days ago with Charlotte when DeMond Brooks fouled out is in a three-point game with Kansas in Kansas City. Without leading scorer DeMond Brooks, who fouled out at the 4:28 mark with 13 points. 1-1 coming here now for Davidson, who is an 80% free throw shooting team, third in the nation. And that's the fourth personal foul on Connor Tehan. Droney, an 86% foul shooter, misses the front end of a 1-1.
80% coming into this game, but below 65% now from the free throw line.
18 rebounds for Thomas Robinson, new career high. Elijah Johnson finds Tehan for three. Robinson then fouls Droney, going for the rebound. Third on Thomas Robinson.
2 minutes and 24 seconds left. Davidson has got to convert at the free throw line. As you mentioned, one of the best in the country at the charity stripe and doing an excellent job getting the rebound. And now you got to make them pay. If it comes down to a free throw competition down the stretch, you favor Davidson in this game, even though they've struggled for a majority of tonight.
Droney hits the front end of this 1-1.
Droney 86% coming into this game from the free throw line.
Tonight only 9 for 14, including that miss of the front end. This time Droney gets them both. 5-point game, 2-possession game, 2:21 to go.
Coach McKillop with a little smile after the made free throws.
You see the timeouts and the bonus situation below the school names. Tyshawn Taylor into the paint. Taylor draws the foul. That's on Cohen. That's number 4.
One of the most impressive things about Davidson is how they've had to work their bench here in the second half with all these guys in foul trouble, utilizing the depth of this roster, maintaining their lead, maintaining their composure.
Surprised that through 12 turnovers in the first half, through all of the foul trouble, Cohen having to sit, Brooks having to sit, Clint Mann having to sit, Cochran having to sit, all those guys limited here in the second half, that Davidson is still up by 4, essentially at Kansas.
They haven't turned it over in the second half, though, Carter. They had 12 at the break. They have 0 turnovers in the second half. That was one of the goals of this coaching staff, and evidently that message was well received by the Wildcats.
Kansas within 3. Davidson led by as many as 11 in the first half here at the Sprint Center in Kansas City. Carter Blackburn with Sean Farnham for the first meeting between Davidson and Kansas since the down-to-the-wire thriller in the 2008 NCAA Tournament Regional Final. Cochran off the screen. 10 to shoot. Kalinowski, the Kansas native, catches on the wing. 5 to shoot. Cochran hoists it and buries it. Nick Cochran with 2 seconds on the shot clock buries the long range 3, and Davidson is a minute 24 away from upsetting the Jayhawks. Taylor can't answer. Davidson ball.
Patience, poise, cool under pressure, and Bill Self is telling his team they got a foul.
Kansas has not hit a 3 this half, down by 6 with a minute 2 to go.
Cochran's 4th three-pointer of the game. A step back, Thomas Robinson in his face. 3 times here in the second half, he has dialed up a 3-pointer when his team has needed it most.
A Davidson team who is averaging about 7 made threes a game has 11 made threes tonight. Bill Self's biggest fear about the Wildcats, they would get hot shooting tonight in Kansas City. Kuhlman makes it an 8-point game. Kansas needs to score in a hurry. Taylor. Big three from Tyshawn Taylor. Timeout, Kansas. Bill Self uses his final. Not going down too many.
Well, especially when you have a player like Thomas Robinson, who's been in a pretty good flow. Now, Robinson just 7 of 17, but he has been a beast.
Taylor comes up. He looks like he didn't mean to foul, but he's going to put Cochran on the free throw line. Just the second personal foul on Taylor. Cochran to the line, and you understand why Taylor didn't want to foul Cochran. 94%. He is sixth in the nation. Mike Venezia of Colgate is number one.
You have to come out of the timeout. You have to know who to foul. Who struggled at the line? Cochran, not the guy that has struggled at all tonight.
Both teams in the double bonus. Davidson leads by 7. Tehan misses the 3. It is Kansas basketball, 41.4 to go.
We try to get Connor Tehan freed up for a 3-point shot. He has not hit his looks tonight.
3 possession game, 41.4 left. Kansas doesn't have a timeout. Robinson misses the dunk down the baseline. Taylor hoists a 3. Davidson basketball, shot clock turned off. Robinson has to foul, and Davidson is 32.3 away from leaving Kansas City with an upset win over 11th-ranked Kansas.
You mentioned it. Only UMass and Syracuse have ever beaten the Jayhawks inside this building, Carter. And what a significant win this will be for the Davidson Wildcats.
Kansas 13-2 here at the Sprint Center. Took Syracuse overtime, UMass in regulation, and a Davidson team who had 12 first-half turnovers. Leading scorer, Damon Brooks, fouls out of the game with 4.5 to go, and yet Bob McKillop's team is turning this into a way too comfortable game in the last 30 seconds. Taylor turns it over. Davidson is going to bring it back with 25 seconds left, up by 9.
A lackadaisical pass by Tyshawn Taylor, and they'll try to get this thing fixed for the Jayhawks before they head out west to take on Kevin O'Neill and the USC Trojans.
So the only losses for Kansas this year against Duke, against Kentucky, and now it's looking like the Davidson Wildcats. What a win for Davidson. And as we talked about, Sean, Bob McKillop saying of this team, they're close. They're close to being a good team, but we need to have that killer instinct in games like this. A 10-point edge on Kansas with 19.5 to go.
Great execution in the second half. It was a 1-point game at the break. 0 turnovers in the second half. I mentioned in the first half, if they don't turn the ball over in the first half, they're probably up by 10 at the break.
Tehan hits a 3. 8-point game. Davidson just has to play keep away. And again, that's Cochran going to the line, the 94% foul shooter.
What a night for Cochran. 20 points for him. The huge 3-pointers in the second half. Late in the shot clock. Every time Kansas made it close, Cochran stepped up. He's towed the line. He's gone 6 for 6 at the free throw line here tonight.
Davidson, just like you would expect from a team shooting 80%. 9 straight free throws made for Davidson to ice this one. Sean, where does Kansas go from here?
some of the same problems that they've had throughout the course of the season. The sloppy play, the turnovers, the careless turnovers. It's just not turnovers. It's how careless they can be. Maybe relying too much on their perimeter shot, not forcing the ball down low, playing through Thomas Robinson.
Johnson buries the three, but that's likely semantics. As Davidson gets to unwrap an early present from underneath the tree, the Davidson Wildcats beat 11th-ranked Kansas 80-74.